All right. In this chapter, I'm going to talk about the existing medical solution to gout or medical treatment for gout, conventional medical treatment for gout and its limitation. So if you're having gout, usually they just manage the symptoms, which is the pain that you are suffering, the inflammation. So amongst the drugs, the common medicine for gout is, the popular one is colchicine. The function of colchicine is to specifically reduce the inflammation of gout. It has been used for many years since a long time ago in different parts of the world. It's an extraction from a plant. It's a poison extract. It's an alkaloid poison extracted from plants. It only used a very tiny little dosage in treating gout inflammation. The popular brand names, it comes with different brand names. The popular ones are Cochrane and Goutnil. These are the function of colchicine specifically to reduce the inflammation, a gouty inflammation. Whereas usually when you go to see doctor, they will give you two types of medicine. They give you a colchicine and then another one is a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, such as aspirin and ibuprofen. The function, same as colchicine, but it used to reduce the inflammation and at the same time reduce the pain. And if your gout attack, this is to address these two, is to specifically address the gout pain that is triggered by the uric acid crystal accumulation in the joint, which is to treat the inflammation. Because like I mentioned before, your gout is because of the formation of new uric crystal, which your body detects as foreign substance, and the white blood cell launch an attack. That's why you get the gout pain or the inflammation. So these two drugs or these two medicines is to treat the inflammation. But if you are suffering very frequent gout attacks and your uric acid is very high, there's a medicine that to reduce your uric acid level, which is the only one, the only one available in the market now. Actually, there's another one, but the popular one is Allopurinol, and it comes with different brand names, Zyroprim and Allopurin. These are how does Allopurinol work? Very interesting. All right, so it says it can reduce uric acid, right? So as I mentioned before, high uric acid is due to what you eat. Means you eat a lot of high protein or high purine food. So when this purine is high level of purine has to be lowered down by sending, your body will send the purine to the liver to be degraded or to be broken down into uric acid. Then it will go back into the bloodstream and send to the kidney for disposal. What does allopurinol do is, it goes to the liver and it blocks this process. So by preventing the breaking down of purine, which means it reduces the production of uric acid into the bloodstream. With that, they lower down the uric acid in the blood, but it doesn't lower down the uric acid in the interstitial fluid and in the joint. So that's why for those of you who has been taking allopurinol, you know how well it works. Actually, yeah, for the first two or three months, yeah, you will see a significant drops of uric acid level after you start consuming allopurinol on a daily basis. But then it will reach a plateau. It stopped dropping because allopurinol only reduces the production of uric acid in the liver, or the breaking down reduces by preventing the breaking down of purine. But it does not take away those already hidden in the interstitial fluid and in the joint. So because it doesn't neutralize it, the concept is they is a blocker. It's some sort of blocker that block the conversion process. So, but the problem is, because purine is something your body doesn't need, you need to get it off, get out of from the body. But if you stop this process by taking allopurinol, yeah, it reduces the production of uric acid. But where does the purine go? You are like setting up a dam that block the conversion of purine into uric acid, but the purine will keep accumulating here. So when you stop taking allopurinol, it's like opening up a floodgate. Then you will see a surge of uric acid and you will get very serious gout attack. So you can try or maybe you already experienced it. Once you stop allopurinol, for some people, if there are a lot of purine stored in the body, then it's like opening a floodgate, then uric acid will surge. So you will develop a dependency towards allopurinol. this is how it works. But in generally, once actually these are is the simple logic is how of this medicine works in dealing with gout or hyperuricemia. But the question is, does any of it address the real root cause of the problem, which is the acid hidden in the joint? So no, none of it does in addressing the root cause of the problem, which is the hidden uric acid, the assisting the deposited uric acid. So that's why there's a limitation on this. There's a bottleneck, or it hits a ceiling. So because the concept is wrong, and not to say wrong, it's not at the right direction. Once you have a clear picture of this and the gout black box I mentioned just now, then you know what is the logical solution to neutralize the acid. That's why I mentioned alkaline water is the only way to free yourself from the torture of gout. All right, that's all for this chapter. Thank you.